Good morning. Today we will start with chemical and phase equilibrium. Equilibrium constant Kp, which is in terms of pressure of the individual reactants and individual products, where this Vc is your, V is your stoichiometric coefficient. So Va, Vb, Vc, Vd are stoichiometric coefficient for complete reaction. Kp can also write in the terms of Gibbs function, change in Gibbs function, that is del G temperature by RT, RUT. So Gibbs function change at same temperature means whatever the change in Gibbs function, we can define Kp. It can also defined in terms of partial, we can replace the partial pressure, and we can replace define in terms of total number of moles present in the chamber to the individual number of moles of the components and reactants. So these are three terms here. Some remarks about Kp of an ideal gas. The Kp of reaction depends on temperature only. It is independent of the pressure of equilibrium mixture and is not affected by presence of inert gas. Inert gas does not affect. They will go as it is. So Kp depends on pressure. Kp is independent of pressure and depends on temperature. So Kp is dependent on del G and T, which depends on temperature only. For inert gas, this value is zero. If this value is zero, thus at a specific temperature, the following four reactions have the same Kp value. This reaction, hydrogen plus half oxygen, which will equilibrate with water at 1 atmospheric, has the same Kp value as for this reaction at different pressure. At this reaction for 3 atmosphere. So these three reactions are at the same Kp value, because Kp value depends on this factor. Standard state Gibbs function change, which is del G, is a function of temperature. It depends on individual stoichiometric coefficient, that Vc, and product of Gibbs at, which is also a function of temperature. For all the components, this is for products, this is for reactants. So means this is a function of temperature only. So this is a function of temperature. Here you had the temperature. So it means Kp is function of temperature only. It is independent of the pressure. Now suppose a case when your reaction become reverse. So in the reversal case, your products become reactants and reactant becomes product. So if del V is positive in one case, in the reverse direction, this del V is negative. If this del V is negative, so you can see that Kp is dependent on pressure of products Pc, Pd, and it is dependent on pressure of reactants and their stoichiometric coefficients. Now in space reaction is reverse. In that case, what will happen? These reactants will become products and products will be reactants. So when you reciprocal this, it means Kp value also reciprocal. In one case suppose it is 10, in another case it will become 1 by 10 when you change the denominator with numerator. The Kp of the reverse reaction is 1 by Kp. This is easily seen from equation. For reverse reaction, the products and reactants switch places and thus the terms in numerator move to denominator and vice versa. Consequently, the equilibrium constant of the reverse reaction becomes 1 by Kp. So suppose if the equilibrium constant for this hydrogen and oxygen reaction is, you can say water at 1000 Kelvin is 0.1147 × 10⁻¹. For this reverse reaction, which is water will dissociate into hydrogen and oxygen at same temperature, will become almost reciprocal. Also you can see here, if Kp value is higher, it means Pc and Pd, means partial pressure of this product is higher. It means during the reaction equilibrium condition, or you can say during the reaction, the product's tendency or formation of products is more if the Kp is higher. If Kp is lesser, it means the product's pressure, or you can say the moles product's formation in the complete reaction is less as compared to in case you had the higher Kp value. You can see if hydrogen has to convert to hydrogen at one pressure, Kp at 1000 is 10⁻¹⁸ approximately, and you can see percentile moles of hydrogen is zero. But when you increase the temperature, your KP value increase, it will 267 and 99.63% of mole of hydrogen is formed. So larger the KP, more complete the reaction. This is also apparent from the equation. If the equilibrium composition consists largely of product gases, the partial pressure of products are considerably large than the partial pressure of reactants, which results in large value of KP. A reaction with KP greater than 1000 is usually assumed to proceed into completion, and a reaction with KP less than 0.01 is assumed not to occur at all. For example, KP is -6.8 for reaction nitrogen when it dissociates into 2N at 5000 Kelvin. Therefore, the dissociation of nitrogen into monatomic nitrogen can be disregarded at a temperature below 5000 Kelvin. It means nitrogen won't dissociate at below 5000 Kelvin. So because KP value is negative, which is not possible, the mixture pressure affects the equilibrium composition, although it does not affect the equilibrium constant KP. So this is the equation here. In this equation, P is the total pressure, this P, and total is the total number of moles present in reaction chamber, and NC, ND, NV, NB are the individual number of moles. Where VC, VD, VA and VV is your stoichiometric coefficient. So if your pressure will change, definitely this del V will change. And this del V can be positive, negative, it can be zero. According to the change in pressure, your reaction can go in any direction and your number of moles will change. So del V will adjust accordingly with pressure without affecting the value of KP. Means at constant temperature, at fixed temperature, the KP will be same. Pressure may change, number of moles, you can say del V, which is the difference of these number of moles of products and reactants, will change. And these two quantities, del V and pressure, will adjust accordingly so that this KP value will remain constant if temperature is fixed. So this can be seen from equation which we had discussed now, which involves the PV raised to power del V, where del V is the summation of stoichiometric coefficient of product minus summation of stoichiometric coefficient of reactant, the difference between number of moles of products and number of moles of reactants in stoichiometric reaction. At a specific temperature, the KP value of reaction and thus the right hand side remains constant. Therefore, the mole number of reactants and the products must change to counteract any change in pressure terms. The direction of change depends on sign of del V. The increase in pressure at a specific temperature increases the number of moles of reactants and decreases in number of moles of products if del V is positive, have opposite effect if del V is negative, and has no effect if del V is zero. If del V is zero, the pressure remains same. The presence of inert gases affects the equilibrium composition, although it does not affect the equilibrium constant KP. Means KP will remain same. This can be seen from equation which we had discussed earlier, which involves the term one way N total raised to power del V, where N total is the total number of moles of ideal gas mixture at equilibrium, including inert gas. The sign of del V determines how the presence of inert gas influences the equilibrium composition. So an increase in number of moles of inert gas as a specific temperature and pressure decrease the number of moles of reactants. You can see in this equation, if inert gas, or you can say if N total will increase, this is N total. If this value will increase, N total, this denominator will increase, this bracketed component will decrease if your N total value will increase. So if this bracketed component here in the bracket, this component will decrease and KP should remain constant during the whole process. To counteract this decrease, this component should increase. If this component should increase, it means the number of moles of product had increased. And if the number of moles of product had increased, means the number of mole of reactant had decreased. So this is the effect of your N total, means total number of moles, that if your N total increases, your number of moles of reactant will decrease, and vice versa for the opposite. Now consider this case when your Kp, equilibrium constant of a chemical reaction, is defined in terms of the pressure of the combustion and pressure of the reactants, and there you can say Pc raised to power Vc, Vc is stoichiometric coefficient, Pd raised to power Vd, and Pa raised to power Va. Now in case when your this Vc, Vd, Va and Vb will double, means your stoichiometric coefficient is doubled. So the whole term will raise to 2. So in that case, your Kp will be squared. So when the stoichiometric coefficient is doubled, the value of Kp is squared. Therefore, when one is using Kp values from a table, the stoichiometric coefficients used in a reaction must be exactly the same ones appearing in the table from which the Kp values are selected. Multiplying all coefficients of a stoichiometric equation does not affect mass balance, but it does affect the equilibrium constant calculations. Strength stoichiometric coefficient appears in exponent of the partial pressure. So you can say here, if you double the number of moles, like 2 hydrogen, 1 oxygen, and instead of 1 water, 2 molecules of water are produced. So this pressure raised to power will increase instead of in this here, if you compare this. And overall, you can say Kp2 is equal to become a Kp1 square. It is always squared. Free electrons in equilibrium composition can be treated as ideal gas. So you can see hydrogen can be distributed in H positive ion and electron. Find the value of this Kp for this reaction. You can see it is a number of moles of hydrogen positive ions raised to power. So it is 1, 1, 1, which is BH positive is 1. So electron, number of moles of electrons, or you can say electron, if there is a 1 electron, it is 1 divided by number of mole of hydrogen, which is again 1 here, and VH, which is 1, that is into P by N total raised to power delta V. So at higher temperature, gas molecules start to dissociate in unattached atoms, such as hydrogen will dissociate into 2H, and even higher temperature atoms start to lose electrons and ionize. The dissociation and ionization effects are more pronounced at low pressure. Ionization occurs to an appreciable extent only at very high temperature, and mixture of electrons, ions and neutral atoms can be treated as an ideal gas. So there is a drawback to this calculation. The equilibrium calculation provides information of equilibrium composition of a reaction, not on reaction rate. Means reaction rate cannot be defined by this verb calculation. Sometimes it may even take years to achieve the indicated equilibrium composition. For example, the equilibrium constant of hydrogen plus half oxygen H2 at 298 Kelvin is about 10 to the power 40, which suggests that a stoichiometric mixture of hydrogen and oxygen at room temperature should react to form H2O. So means at 298 Kelvin, they will form H2O. But the reaction should go to completion and reaction should go completion. However, the rate of this reaction is so slow that it particularly does not occur. But when the right catalyst is used, the reaction goes to completion rather quickly to the predicted values. So means it will give incomplete information. It does not give any information about the reaction rate. Equilibrium composition at a specific temperature. We will use the relation for Kp for to find the equilibrium composition at a specific temperature. Suppose a mixture of 2 kmol of CO and 3 kmol of oxygen is heated to 2600 Kelvin at a pressure of 304 kPa. So we have 2 kmol of CO and 3 kmol of oxygen. It is heated to 2600 Kelvin at 304 kPa. So it will form CO2, carbon monoxide and oxygen. Determine the equilibrium composition assuming the mixture consists of CO2, carbon monoxide or oxygen. The equilibrium composition consists of CO2, carbon monoxide and oxygen. The constituent mixture are ideal gases. The stoichiometric and actual reactions in this case. So this is your stoichiometric reaction. Carbon monoxide plus half oxygen will form CO2. And this is your number of stoichiometric coefficient. For CO it is 1, for CO2 it is 1, and for oxygen it is half. But in the actual case, we had, if you multiply by 2, this is 2 carbon monoxide plus 3 oxygen, which will form, we had 3 products here. You can see CO2, carbon monoxide, oxygen. So it will form CO2, x mole of say CO2 y mole of carbon monoxide and z mole of oxygen. So now balance in this equation in actual reaction. So 2 carbon is equal to x plus y, where here we get y in terms of x. Now balance oxygen, total oxygen is here is 3 into 2 plus 2, 3 into 2 is 6 plus 2 is equal to 8, is equal to here it is 2 x plus y plus here it is 2 z. So or z in terms of x. So now we had this you can say for this balance reaction we had this one x, y and z, which is the coefficient of how many number of moles CO2, carbon monoxide and oxygen. Now total number of moles is equal to this x plus y plus z. So sum of this and x is equal to 5 minus x by 2. And pressure is 3.4 kilopascal or is equal to 3 atmosphere. So the closer reaction listed in this table, that is A28, is CO2 for carbon monoxide and oxygen, for which log Kp is equal to minus 2.801. So for this reaction, this log Kp value is given at 2600 Kelvin, so which is the nearest temperature, and corresponding closest reaction. So this reaction, but here we had this reaction. So for this reaction, if you have to find this log Kp, this will be reversed. If the reaction will be reversed, so for log Kp here is plus 2.801, and when you take log on this side, Kp is equal to 16.461 in this case. Now Kp we know that is 16.461. It is dependent on this pressure, which is 3 atmosphere. We know total number of molecules, which is here 5 minus x by 2, and this del V. Now what is del V? This is change in the stoichiometric coefficient of product minus reactant. So it is, you can see this is our product CO2 and reactant is this. So it is minus half. N we had calculated here. N for CO2 is your this one x. N for carbon monoxide is y, which is 2 minus x. N for oxygen is equal to 3 minus x by 2. Here for oxygen, and when you solve this you will get a value of x. Now you know the x, you can find y and z. X is 1.906, put here and here you will get y and z. So y and z are here, so you will get this equation. Therefore the equivalent coefficient of mixture at 2600 Kelvin at 304 kilopascal or 3 bar is 1.906 CO2 plus 0.094 carbon monoxide plus 2.07 for oxygen. So this is up to the equilibrium composition at particular temperature and pressure. Effect of inert gases on equilibrium composition: a mixture of 3 kmol of carbon monoxide, 2.5 kmol of oxygen and 8 kmol of nitrogen is heated to 2600 Kelvin at a pressure of 5 atmosphere. Determine the equilibrium composition of the mixture. So 3 kmol of carbon monoxide, 2.5 kmol of oxygen, 8 kmol of nitrogen, they are heated at 2600 Kelvin and 5 atmosphere pressure. So these are the products: carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, oxygen. This is the same as in the previous example. Nitrogen is the net gas. So except that it involves the nitrogen, which at 2600 Kelvin. So some possible reactions for like oxygen, for which log is negative, log Kp is negative, it is not possible. Nitrogen will dissociate. For this also log is negative, log Kp is negative. So this won't happen. For this reaction, is it also negative? So this reaction also won't happen. Means oxygen nitrogen won't react to form nitrogen oxide at this temperature. What is possible? That is carbon monoxide and half oxygen CO2. For this reaction, log Kp is equal to 2.801 or Kp is equal to 16.461. As we know, if Kp is positive, the reaction will happen. So this reaction is feasible. So same here, we write stoichiometric reaction for carbon monoxide, oxygen and CO2, which is this one. Actual reaction here is 3 carbon monoxide plus 2.5 oxygen as given here, 3 kmol of carbon monoxide, 2.5 kmol of oxygen plus 8 kmol of nitrogen, which will form say x CO2, y carbon monoxide, z oxygen and this will act as a net gas as it is. Now balance this equation. You will find x, y and z here. After calculation of x, y, z, this is our total sum of x, y, z and total number of moles of the products. So this and total is total number of products, that is 13.5 minus x by 2. Apply the equation, assuming ideal gas behavior for all components, the equilibrium constant relation. So this is equilibrium constant Kp is equal to P, here P is 5 atmosphere given and total is this value. This is again same as in the previous case, which is minus 1 by 2. N CO2, which is X, N carbon monoxide is 2.5 minus X by 2. And this your for carbon it is 3 minus X. And when you raise this power VCO2, this is your stoichiometric coefficient, you will get X is equal to 2.754. Put this value X here, 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 you will get X, Y, Z and the composition of the products. So this is your composition of products, 2.75 CO2 plus put to 0.246 carbon monoxide plus 1.123 oxygen and 8 nitrogen. So therefore equal composition of mixture at 2600 Kelvin and 5 atmosphere is here. Note that the net gases do not affect Kp value or the Kp relation for the reaction, but they do affect the equilibrium composition. Means equilibrium composition is different, but they don't affect this Kp value, which is listed over here. This value will for this reaction will remain same, which is as in the previous case, this Kp value. Chemical equilibrium for simultaneous reactions. The reacting mixtures we have considered so far involved only one reaction. And writing a Kp relation for that reaction was sufficient to determine the equilibrium composition of mixture. However, most practical chemical reactions involve two or more reactions that occur simultaneously, which makes them more difficult to deal with. In such case, it becomes necessary to apply the equilibrium criteria to all possible reactions that may occur in the reaction chamber. When a chemical species appear in more than one reaction, we'll discuss with the help of example. Say water and oxygen is heated at 4000 Kelvin at a pressure of 1 atmosphere. Equilibrium composition of this mixture, assuming that H2O, OH, oxygen at H2O are present, means these two will react. This is the initial composition and equilibrium condition composition is at 4001 atmosphere is water, hydrogen, oxygen and OH. Now in this case, when you solve this equation, this is your reaction here, H2O plus 2O2, which will form H2O, hydrogen, oxygen and OH. We had four unknowns here, which is X, Y, Z and W. When you see here clearly, we had only two elements, that is hydrogen and oxygen. On the reactant side, we had only two elements, individual elements, like oxygen is element, hydrogen is element, and this is called say H2, this is one species, hydrogen is second species, oxygen other species and OH is chemical species. So we had only two elements, that is oxygen and hydrogen, but species are four, this. Now we know we had four unknowns, X, Y, Z and W. The determination of equilibrium composition of a reacting mixture requires that we had as many equations as unknowns, where the unknowns are the number of moles of each chemical species present in the equilibrium mixture. So in this case, we had total four unknowns, X, Y, Z and W. The mass balance of each element involves provide only one equation. So here is the mass balance for hydrogen and oxygen, which yield only, so one mass balance of one element, which is hydrogen, will provide one equation. One mass balance for oxygen will provide another equation. So in this case, we had only two equations, that is hydrogen balance, mass balance and oxygen mass balance, but variables are four, X, Y, Z and W. So as we know from our mathematical point of view, if there are four unknowns, means there must be four equations, but here we had four unknowns and equations are only two. The rest two of equations must come from Kp relations written for each reaction. Thus, we conclude that the number of Kp relations needed to determine the equilibrium composition of a reactive mixture is equal to number of chemical species minus number of elements present in equilibrium. Or we can say we need two more Kp relations. Means instead of one Kp relation, in the previous case we had one Kp relation, which is not sufficient. We need two Kp relations to solve this equation. Means we need two more equations. So this is the number of Kp relation. Kp relation is equal to the number of components or chemical species minus number of elements. Here we have elements is 2 and number of species are 4. So we need two Kp relations in this case. From where we will take this Kp relation? So consider that H2O will convert to H2 plus half oxygen. This is the case, and H2O will form hydrogen, half hydrogen plus OH. So these are two reactions. So we will take Kp relation for this reaction and we will write Kp relation for this reaction. Here in this case, Kp for these two reactions is 0.51816 for this first reaction, and Kp for second reaction is 0.9570. Now solve for these two Kp reactions. Kp1, again pressure is given 1 atmospheric, and total in this case for X plus Y plus Z plus W. So N hydrogen is Y, N oxygen is Z, so YZ raised to power half divided by NH2, which is water, is X. So N hydrogen is Y raised to power half, OH is W here in this reaction. So now you have two more equations. So this is your first equation, second, third and fourth. And you can solve this equation jointly. You will get four equations, four unknowns. You will get X, Y, Z and W. Therefore, equilibrium composition of H2O, 1 kmol H2 and 2 kmol oxygen at 1 atmosphere pressure and 400 Kelvin is this one. You had X, Y, Z, W. Put the values in the original equation. So like this video, subscribe this channel, and thank you for watching this video.